mostly adult specimens here, and another day, another hunt for Antikuna. In this area, we're going to search for Antikuna cyanofemur, which is one of the most beautiful species of this newly established genus. As always, we are next to a road, but this road is extremely bumpy and not that great to actually drive anyway, any further. So we will try and focus to find the species in this area. Nevertheless, it is an amazingly dry habitat on one side of the valley, and on the other side it is way more moist. So we will see on which side this species actually lives. Of course we have GPS locality data, but this is all way up 4,500 meters above sea level. So therefore we'll focus in this area, which is a little bit lower and should still hopefully. So yeah. That's all for it. We'll continue searching and hopefully we'll find one.
Now it took us just a few minutes of search, but then all this amazing landscape and beautiful scenery until we found our first specimen. It was a juvenile specimen, but already fully colored. I mean, look at these colors. They have amazing purple bluish hue all over the body. And some really nice looking red hair, especially at the place where abdomen and carapax, like front and back, meets up. There are so many red hairs. That's really a distinct feature of the whole genus Antikuna, because we see that in every species of Antikuna so far, but not in every species it's that prominent, because look at that contrast. Now this juvenile specimen was the perfect model. I was able to get some really nice walking shots, as you see, and that's really rare, because when you film in the wild, you never know what's going to happen next.
Now the search is successful. We managed to find a small specimen of Antikuna cyanofemur. I don't know if you can see it, but later on in the macro shots and macro video, we'll most likely be able to see it way better than now. It is a small juvenile specimen, not fully adult yet, and of course the coloration is nowhere near the adult female's coloration with its blue femurs. But nevertheless, we found it, and I'm extremely happy to see this species in the wild. I'm extremely grateful to be part of that amazing project and research project where we were able to describe this new genus, including seven new species of highland Andean teraphosid species. So we will focus on searching some more specimens, of course, and hopefully we're going to find a bigger one with the almost adult coloration. That would be amazing. So wish us luck, and in the meanwhile, enjoy some of the surroundings here and enjoy how the habitat actually looks like. It is just an amazingly beautiful place, yeah, quite amazed, to be honest.
Now, the genus Antikuna is a relatively new genus described in 2021, meaning that it's only 3 years old. At the moment, there are 7 species within this genus, and this Antikuna cyanofemur is one of them. Actually, the more I look at the specimen, the more I think this could be a new species, because it does not match up with the locality with cyanofemur, and also the looks of it do look a little bit different. Of course, as the name suggests, cyano for blue and femur for the part of the leg, which is the femur, of course, it should resemble that it has a blue femur. But not only the femur is blue or purple, the whole body is purple. I mean, look at that. And the prominent orange-red markings on this slightly green abdomen? Never seen before. And it does not match up 100% with the first description of Antikuna cyanofemur. We are super happy that we found an adult female, freshly molted more or less, and some juvenile specimens we were able to document. Now here, a little bit in more broad daylight, you see that the color vanishes a little bit, but still, if you look close enough, there is a huge, amazing purple hue all over the body, and these red hairs are so contrasty. I mean, look at it.
So we managed to find Antikuna cyanofemur here in this mostly rocky and arid habitat. These are potentially subadult specimens, so we have not seen fully adults yet. But you can still see the slight violet coloration on its femurs, and they tend to grow a little bit bigger than this. So amazing find. We did find 3 adult, mostly adult specimens here, and yeah, we'll release her back into its burrow and get some pictures and videos beforehand, and then continue our journey in this amazing highland of Peru itself. We'll give you some impressions of the habitat here, so you know how this species actually lives, and very happy to have found this one here.
Return the specimen back into its burrow. And then gently put the rock back